Today is Mass for Ramiro Jimenez, Jose Salcedo, and today is the feast of St. Joseph, St. Christopher Magallanes, Presbítero, and Compañeros, Martyrs. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with you.
Prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Let us call to mind our sins. For all the times we have failed to love God our Father, we pray, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, who made the priest Saint Christopher Magallanes and his companions faithful to Christ the King, even to the point of martyrdom, grant us through their intercession that persevering in confession of the true faith, we may always hold fast the commandments of your love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul left Athens and went to Corinth. There he met a Jew named Aquila, a native of Pontus, who had recently come from Italy with his wife Priscilla, because Claudius had ordered all the Jews to leave Rome. He went to visit them, and because he practiced the same trade, stayed with them and worked, for they were tent makers by trade. Every Sabbath, he entered into discussions in the synagogue, attempting to convince both Jews and Greeks. When Silas and Timothy came down from Macedonia, Paul began to occupy himself totally with preaching the word, testifying to the Jews that Christ was Jesus. When they opposed him and reviled him, he shook off his garments and said to them, "Your blood be on your heads. I am clear of responsibility. From now on, I will go to the Gentiles." So he left there and went to a house belonging to a man named Titus Justus, a worshiper of God. His house was next to the synagogue. Crispus, the synagogue official, came to believe in the Lord, along with his entire household. And many of the Corinthians who heard, believed, and were baptized. The word of the Lord. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for him, his holy arm.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
The Lord has made his salvation known. In the sight of the nations, he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and faithfulness towards the house of Israel.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song, sing praise.
The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power.
According to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Amen, amen, I say to you, unless grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. Whoever loves his life loses it, and whoever hates his life in this world will preserve it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there also will my servants be. The Father will honor whoever serves me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today, as we mentioned in the beginning of the Mass, is the feast of St. Christopher Magallanes and some 22 other diocesan priests and three laymen who were martyred during the 20s of during the Cristero movement. And the Church recently canonized these men and followers of Christ. And the gospel we use today is a traditional gospel for a Mass of a martyr, because it is so crystal clear what the life of a martyr and his death means to us. His life was a life of self-denial, of sacrifice. And then the comparison is made by Christ: unless that piece of wheat dies and buried in the ground, it cannot bear fruit. And so it is with the blood of the martyrs, especially the people who still remember those days in front of our church, La Doña Maria Mesa, who will shortly be 100 years old. Her father was martyred, and she remembers the gunshot that killed her father because he housed and gave hospitality to a priest to say Mass for that region. And for that crime, he was shot summarily. So there are many, many martyrs, many, many people who have defended the faith, and they, from time to time, the Church reminds of these people to give us encouragement and to have ourselves go forward. My brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. In honor of the precious death of your just ones, O Lord, we come to offer that sacrifice from which all martyrdom draws its origin, through Christ our Lord. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, and at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to love you yet more gloriously. brought the sacrifice of all to fulfillment, the reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, and together sing the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, unto you of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Tonight, as one family of God, we pray together the words that Jesus taught us as we say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. And graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we are always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Spiritual communion, my Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things. I desire to possess you within my soul. Since I am unable at this moment to receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as being already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Christopher, my elders and companions. We beseech you, Lord, to bestow victory on those who eat here below of the bread of life, and to allow them to eat as victors in the tree of life in paradise, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.